The Amazon holds more undiscovered species than nearly any place on Earth. Scientists have catalogued thousands, but they believe thousands more remain hidden in the dark waters, waiting. What's unsettling is that some creatures they have found are so alien-looking, so nightmarish, they barely seem real. And the first on our list? A parasite so terrifying, locals won't even say its name aloud. Meet the candiru, the Amazon's real-life vampire. This tiny, nearly transparent catfish is only a few inches long, but it strikes more fear into locals than piranhas ever could. Why? Because this thing doesn't hunt flesh. It hunts holes. Yes, holes. Attracted by the scent of urea, it's known for swimming straight into the gill slits of other fish, and disturbingly, into human orifices. That's right. Eyewitness reports and a few horrifying case studies describe it invading swimmers' bodies, locking in with backward-pointing spines, and refusing to come out. Surgical removal is the only option. Many scientists once thought this was myth until they documented real medical cases. It's rare, but it's real. And it's enough to keep even thrill seekers out of the water. But what if something bigger could kill you with electricity? It doesn't look like a monster, more like a fat, tired snake, but don't be fooled. The electric eel of the Amazon is one of the deadliest animals in the river, and not because of its bite. This thing delivers electric shocks of up to 600 volts. That's 5 times what comes out of your wall socket, enough to knock out a grown man and, in rare cases, even cause death. What's even creepier? They use electricity not just to hunt, but to see. In the pitch black murk, electric eels send out pulses that bounce off objects, helping them map their surroundings in real time. It's like radar, except deadly. And here's the kicker. New species of electric eel were recently discovered that produce even stronger shocks than we thought possible. But electric danger is just the beginning. What about teeth? Rows of razor-sharp teeth that can shred flesh in seconds. You've heard the legends. Swimmers skeletonized in seconds. Rivers that boil with red frenzy. While some of those stories are exaggerated, the truth about piranhas is still terrifying. Found all over the Amazon basin, the red-bellied piranha is the most feared. They're not large, just about a foot long, but when they swarm, they act like a buzzsaw. One moment the water is calm, and the next, it's churning with dozens of them, their teeth like rows of tiny steak knives. They're attracted to blood, noise, even splashing. And while attacks on humans are rare, they do happen. There have been recorded cases of injuries, and in extreme situations, deaths. But it's not just predators you have to worry about in the Amazon. Some creatures simply shouldn't be alive at all, like this next one, a fish that breathes air. If you drained the Amazon overnight, some fish wouldn't even care. The lungfish is one of the strangest survivors in the river. It doesn't just have gills, it has lungs. Real lungs, like ours. In dry seasons, when water vanishes, it burrows into the mud and enters a kind of hibernation, breathing through a hole in the soil. It can stay like that for months, sometimes even longer. No water, no food, just waiting for the rains to come back. What's wild is this ability isn't new, it's ancient. Scientists believe lungfish are evolutionary relics, unchanged for over 400 million years. That makes them older than dinosaurs. They were here before anything walked on land. But what if something even bigger was hiding in the same waters, thick, silent, and hungry? It's not a myth. It's not a legend. It's the green anaconda, the largest and heaviest snake on Earth, and it thrives in the swamps and waters of the Amazon. Some grow longer than 30 feet and weigh over 500 pounds. That's heavier than a grand piano. Anacondas are ambush predators. They lurk beneath the surface like living ropes, completely still, then explode with crushing force. One bite, one wrap of their coils, and the fight is over. Capybaras, caimans, even jaguars, nothing is off limits. What makes them more terrifying is how stealthy they are. Locals often never see them until it's too late. A ripple in the water, a sudden silence, and then gone. But not everything in the river is monstrous. Some of it looks charming until you learn its secret. They're pink, they're playful, they seem innocent. But the Amazon River dolphin, also known as the boto, has a strange reputation. In local folklore, it's feared. Said to transform into a man at night and seduce women, this dolphin has a long history of mystery. But science has its own reason to raise eyebrows. River dolphins have incredibly flexible necks and sharp intelligence. They hunt in murky waters using echolocation, twisting and turning in eerie, almost human-like ways. Some scientists believe their behavior shows signs of advanced cognition, possibly even rivaling that of primates. And there's more. These dolphins have been known to display aggressive, even violent behavior toward other animals. In one study, a dolphin was seen playing with, but also mutilating, a freshwater turtle for no apparent reason. But let's bring it back to teeth. Big ones. Human ones. It looks like a joke until it bites. The pacu is a cousin of the piranha, but instead of razor teeth, it has flat, square ones. And they look exactly like a human's. Seriously, incisors, molars, the whole unsettling package. Native to the Amazon, pacu fish are usually herbivores. But don't let that calm you down. There have been strange incidents, including one alarming report out of Papua New Guinea, where pacu were introduced, involving attacks on male swimmers. Let's just say they bit where no one should be bitten. Some even call them bull cutters. While exaggerated, the rumors added to their already creepy reputation. And yet, they're just one example of how alien the Amazon's fish life can get. Because the next creature, it wears armor and grows longer than a grown man. They call it the piraiba, a true river monster. This species of catfish can grow longer than 10 feet and weigh over 400 pounds. That's heavier than most people. But it's not just the size that's shocking, it's the appearance. The piraiba looks prehistoric, with thick, bony plates and massive jaws. These catfish are apex predators in their environment. Unlike bottom-feeding catfish you're used to, the piraiba is an aggressive hunter. It's been known to eat other large fish, crustaceans, and possibly even small mammals. Fishermen have pulled up half-eaten piranhas from inside them. Some claim they've seen these beasts drag smaller animals underwater. It's like pulling up a relic from another world. And just when you think the Amazon couldn't get more horrifying, the next creature lives inside you. In the Amazon, danger isn't always outside the body. Sometimes it's inside, and nothing proves that better than the parasitic worms found in the region. These things are the stuff of nightmares. Some burrow under your skin, some travel through your bloodstream, and a few even invade your eyeballs. One of the worst is the loa-loa, also called the eye worm. It can actually be seen squirming across the eye while you're still awake. Others, like certain nematodes, can grow inside organs and live for years undetected. These parasites often come from contaminated water or through mosquito bites. They're not just painful, they're debilitating. In extreme cases, they can lead to blindness, seizures, or even death. But not all creepy Amazon dwellers are small. The next one, it can actually walk on land. Yes, you read that right. Some Amazon fish can walk on land. One of the most bizarre examples is the knifefish, a species that, when water levels drop, can use its muscular body to slither across mud and shallow ground in search of a better home. But it's not alone. Some species of catfish, like the armored catfish, also crawl out of drying rivers, using their fins and strong bodies to push themselves across land. These fish don't need much water to survive. Some can breathe through their skin, others gulp air like the lungfish. It's a desperate move, sure, but in the Amazon, when water dries up, survival belongs to the weirdest. But if that's not strange enough, wait till you meet a river stingray the size of a dining table. It lurks on the bottom, buried under silt. You might never know it's there until it's too late. The giant freshwater stingray is one of the Amazon's most mysterious creatures. With a body that can span over 6 feet wide and a tail like a whip, this thing is as powerful as it is silent. What makes it terrifying isn't just its size, it's the venomous barb on its tail. If stepped on or threatened, the ray can stab with bone-piercing force, injecting venom that causes excruciating pain, tissue damage, and in some cases, death. Many locals fear them more than piranhas. They blend in with the riverbed, invisible, until you're right on top of them. And while stingrays usually don't attack unprovoked in murky water, accidents happen. But get this, something even more out of place lives in the river. Something you'd expect in the ocean, not fresh water. It sounds made up, but it's real. The Amazon is home to a freshwater jellyfish called Craspedacusta sauerbii. This tiny, translucent creature drifts through calm stretches of the river, pulsing gently like its saltwater cousins. It doesn't sting humans, at least not with any force you'd notice, but its very presence is baffling. Jellyfish are supposed to be ocean dwellers. How did one end up thousands of miles inland, in fresh water? Scientists believe these jellyfish may have traveled across the globe via water plants and stuck around in just the right warm, still waters. They're fragile, barely an inch wide, and often invisible until the light hits them just right. But they prove one thing clearly. In the Amazon, anything is possible. Still, some creatures don't float. They drip, they ooze, and they kill without biting. The Amazon is home to some of the most toxic animals on Earth, and they don't even need fangs or claws. Meet the poison dart frog. Brightly colored, no bigger than a coin, and absolutely deadly. Just one of these frogs can carry enough toxin to kill 10 men. They don't inject venom, they secrete it through their skin. Indigenous tribes once used their secretions to coat the tips of blow darts, hence the name. What's wild is these frogs aren't born poisonous. They gain their toxins by eating certain insects found only in their native environments. And guess what? Some fish and river-dwelling creatures may also carry toxins, substances that researchers are only beginning to understand. But we're not done with the weird yet. The next fish, you can see through its skin and watch its heart beat. In the pitch-black waters of the Amazon, nature gets strange. Enter the glass knifefish, a translucent wonder with a ribbon-like body and organs you can literally see from the outside. It looks more like a ghost than a fish. It's completely see-through, no scales, no pigment, just a faint shimmer as it glides by. But it's not just its look that's weird. It uses electric fields to sense its surroundings, like a living radar. Scientists believe this ability helps it navigate in the darkest parts of the river, where not even sunlight reaches. It's fragile, eerie, and incredibly rare to spot. But not all Amazon creatures avoid the spotlight. The next one? It's loud, aggressive, and shockingly cute until it opens its jaws. They look like playful dogs in the water until they bare their teeth. The giant otter of the Amazon can grow over 6 feet long and weighs more than 70 pounds. That's not your average fuzzy mammal. These apex predators are smart, fast, and hunt in packs. Working as a team, they've been seen taking down large fish, caimans, and even defending themselves against jaguars. With jaws strong enough to crush bone and a high-pitched scream that carries over water, they're the Amazon's most unexpected power players. Don't be fooled by their cuddly appearance. These creatures are fierce, vocal, and highly territorial. Cross them, and you'll quickly find out why locals call them river wolves. And speaking of power, the next fish doesn't just swim, it leaps out of the water like a missile. Meet the arapaima, one of the largest freshwater fish in the world. Some grow longer than 10 feet and weigh over 400 pounds, but what makes them truly insane is what they do above the water. Arapaimas can leap out with explosive force, sometimes over 6 feet in the air, using their massive tails to launch themselves like living torpedoes. And when they slam down, they hit with enough power to knock a person off a boat. These fish are also ancient survivors, with thick armored scales that protect them from piranhas and other predators. They come up to gulp air, much like lungfish, making them even more strange. But now it's time to head back underground, literally, because the next threat lives inside your body. Not all river monsters are massive. Some are microscopic and horrifying. Certain parasitic nematodes and worms found in the Amazon can travel from the digestive system up into the eye, brain, and spinal cord. One moment you have stomach cramps, the next you're losing your vision. A common carrier? Contaminated water or undercooked river fish. These parasites don't kill fast, they destroy slowly. Some cases reported in rural Amazonian regions have left victims with long-term nerve damage and blindness. What's worse, some of these parasites are so rare, doctors don't always recognize them in time. And as scientists dig deeper into the Amazon's ecosystem, they keep finding new species. That brings us to... In the past few decades, researchers have discovered hundreds of new Amazon fish species, from glowing tetras to bizarre-looking armored catfish with spines and suction cup mouths. And these discoveries are still coming. Some new finds include miniature eels with oversized jaws, freshwater gobies with venomous fins, and translucent catfish that shimmer in the dark. Every expedition seems to uncover something new, something strange. And while most are small, some could become serious threats to the balance of the ecosystem, or even to humans. The Amazon remains one of the least explored regions on Earth. But it leads to one final question. We've only scratched the surface. Scientists estimate that over half of the Amazon's aquatic species remain undocumented. That means thousands of fish, invertebrates, reptiles, and amphibians could still be hiding, unseen, untouched, and totally unknown to science. What lives in the deepest pockets of this muddy giant? What's in the flooded caves, the seasonal lakes, the hidden underwater tunnels? We don't know. But we do know this. The Amazon River holds more mystery than any other body of water on the planet, and every ripple, every shadow, every sudden splash in the dark might just be something the world has never seen before.